So very good afternoon to all the students. So I think I'm audible to all of you. Can you hear me? Yeah, hello everyone. So we'll be just starting in 2 more minutes. Okay, we are just waiting other students to join. Okay, thank you for responding yes on the chat box. Okay, so there are many things actually, students, today what we would like to cover. So we will be teaching you about the, you can already see on the screen that how you can make a story, and today's session name is Once Upon a Time, and we will be telling you how you can create a story. Also along with that, we will be letting you know that how you are going to work, like how you are going to submit your work in the, like in your, I should say, in your dashboard. Also along with that, how you can reach us. So I know many students were finding problem in asking the questions and asking their doubts. So, but we have an now a good option where you will be directly connected to us. Okay. So before starting the session, I would like to know some of the questions, some of the answers from you. So like, is everything was clear in yesterday's session? So did you all tried? Please answer me. Yeah, I'll share you my number, but don't worry. Today I'll share you one option so that you can keep me asking the questions and I'll try to respond you on that. Okay. So may I know, like, did you all meet the yesterday's project? Was everything clear? Okay, I can see. Yes, okay. So I'll just So I'm just sending you a poll, student. I want all of you to answer this. So did you meet the project of yesterday? So still I can see some no here, and that we definitely don't want. Okay, I can see a good number here, like maximum of you have like completed it. Okay, it's good. It's really nice. So today we will be like letting you know how you can work with it and how you can like submit your assignments and everything. You don't have to worry with that. Okay, so also I would like to know, like, if the students have not, okay, so some of you are finding some trouble. Okay, so as like today I will be showing you the place where you can ask your doubt. So there you can let me know, like, if you are having any problem with PictoBlocks or if you are not able to make that projects. Okay. Okay, great. So I think now we are good to start. So yeah, Pramod sir, shall we start for today?
Yes, I think this is the right time. Almost time. Yeah, that's correct. I just want to say one thing. Today actually the interesting thing start, because this story is like here, telling them how to create a story, my story with character, but what they are learning is actually the programming. So it becomes a very interesting thing. So I look forward to today's class. So with that, it is over to you.
Yeah, sure, sir. So like Pramod sir said, students, that today is one of the very important lesson, because this will give you to create your own animations and own story, because you will be learning artificial intelligence. But to showcase your skill, you will be in need of having a story, right? So this is going to something add on, like add on some good views in your project, which you will be making. Okay, so I won't take much more of your time, and let's start with today's session. So it's really nice. So yeah, Harshita, if you're finding a problem with PictoBlocks, I'll tell you how you can reach out to us. Okay. And we'll help you with each and every solution. Like if your PictoBlocks is not working, you are not able to download, or if any of the problem you are facing, we'll help you with that. Don't worry. Okay. Okay. So let's start our today's session. So students, you can already see that today's topic is Once Upon a Time. And here we are here. Basically, we are going to teach you how you can make the stories, right? So now what exactly is making, what we are doing, we are going to do in this activity is we are going to, so yesterday we just saw some of the, I'll tell you each and everything, students, how you can do it in Android phones and everything. Don't worry. Okay. And also like some of the questions were asked by some students. So there is no WhatsApp group separately for the bootcamp students. Okay. What we have done this time is you can ask your doubts to your executive, to your teachers. Okay. And also you have my number, which I'll be sharing it to you. Okay. So you can always reach out to us. And the best way is you can let us know while, via the website. So today I'm going to explain you all those things. Okay. So yeah, students, about the PictoBlocks, so I can see some of the students are finding some trouble with update or anything. So I'll tell you how you can resolve those problems. You don't have to worry with that. It's very simple steps, okay? But as it is like a some of the things have to be done personally, so I won't take those things in the session, but I'll tell you how you can reach to me personally so that I can help you all the students like giving one-on-one time, okay? So like in this activity, you can see we are having a two sprites. So yesterday what we did was we just worked with a single sprite and we tried to, as I said, like we tried to make our Toby walk on the beach, right? But if in case I want to make a story, as I said, like what we are going to do today, so how we can do that? How we can use multiple sprite? Okay, so we are going to work with this in today's session. So all these things are, as I said, like you will be accessing in your dashboard that how you can choose the, I should say, how you can choose backdrop and everything. But on here, we will do all the live things. So I'm going to explain you all these things very on the live. So just give me a moment. So I'll stop this presentation. I'll take you directly to the PictoBlocks where we are going to do this part, okay? So now I hope you can all can see my PictoBlocks screen. So as I said, like today we will try to do in both the things, like we are first I'm going to tell you how you can do it in your laptop desktop. Also, I will try to show you how you can do it in your PCs, in your Android phones. Okay, so we will cover these things and then I'll take you to the Android part. Okay, so here students, for making the story, like we all know that story, making story with a single sprite is little difficult. So that's why we are going to choose multiple sprites. So how we can do that? So for we will choose 2 to 3 sprites here from the library. So for choosing the sprite, you can directly go to a choose sprite option. And let's, as I said in the yesterday's session as well, that for making a good program, the most important thing is a planning. Okay, so for planning, let's plan first what we are going to make. So we are going to make a story where we will have a fox and we can have a lion with us. Okay, and we will try to make a conversation over there, okay, between them in search of water. So this is our plan. And now to move ahead in the plan, I need the lion and the fox. So I'll directly go here on the animals. Okay. And I'll just find the lion. So now here you can see students, here is the lion. So I'll just select this and I don't need Toby today. So you can delete the already existing sprite. Okay, from here, like you can see there is a delete option. You can just click it here and it will be deleted. Now the second sprite I want is a fox. So what I can do, so right now I just told you a way to just select an animal and find it. Now even you can just write what you want on the search tab and it will give you directly the sprite. So I'll just select fox here. Now students, you can see there are basically two animals on the screen now. Now, of course, there should be a background. Okay, so to choose a background, we have an option of a backdrop. I'll just go to choose backdrop option and I'll just select a backdrop. Let's take it a jungle. So again, you can directly just search it down here. And let's take this jungle. And now you can see my sprites are somewhere standing here. Okay, now we have set up the environment, or you can say we can set up an prerequisites where I got the sprites, I got the backdrop and everything is good. But now we have to start coding. And why we want to do this? Because we want to complete a story. So the first part which you are looking in, this is very, very important. So I want every student to focus here. So every time, and even in humans or in anywhere, if we are talking to, we talk to each other by just seeing each other, like we talk to each other by facing each other, right? So, but here you can see the fox is not facing towards the lion. So now the first important thing what we have to do is we have to make this fox looking towards the lion. So now how can we do that? So here, students, the concept I'll explain you is, you can see this is lion and this is fox. So like in the movies or in the like theaters, you might have already seen that every character, okay, in any cartoon as well, every character has their own script. Okay, so they follow the set of instructions given to them. So here, students, on the bottom side, you can see one is lion and one is fox. So if you are selecting a lion and if you are going to put any number of blocks, so these will be dedicatedly only working for the lion. This is not going to work for the fox. So because if I'm just selecting fox here, so you can see there are no blocks. So you have to keep in mind that which sprite have you selected and where you are putting the blocks. So as of now, I'll just remove the blocks. And as we have decided that first we have to start with making the fox face towards the lion. So how we can do that? So we will select fox. And students, you can see there is an option of direction. So if I'm going to move this, you will be able to see fox rotating, right? You can see, so just to show you what I'm going to do is I'll just bring this fox somewhere here. Okay, now this will show you. So now here you can see, if I'm rotating this, this is just rotating the fox, right? So what I can do? So initially it was something like that. If I want to make it face towards the lion, so I can choose this option, right? But how we can do it using a block? So what I'm going to show you here is you have an option, point direction. Okay, so now I'll just choose point direction and I'll just make it minus 90 degree. So this will, now you can see the fox is facing towards the lion, but again it is on the upside down. So how we can change this is we will set the rotation style from left to right. Okay, so now you can see with these two blocks, okay, so this is very important concept that you can see here that I just rotated the sprite and now they are looking to each other. Now students, we of course want to see an animation. Okay, so in animation, you know, we would be requiring the movement from here of lion to somewhere here, right? So how we can do that? So we have to first fix the initial position of both the sprites. So let's fix the lion's position. So I can hold this and I can just rotate it. So I'll just set this as an initial position. Okay. So now to set this as an initial position, you have an option is go to X and Y. So I'll show you some changes here. So here you can see if I'm just changing the lion's position. So you can see on the left hand side on the blocks, you can see the different, the change in X and Y coordinates, right? So I will just fix my lion somewhere here. Okay. And then I'll take down this. So what it will help me to, so if in case my lion started walking from here, it walked through somewhere here and I want to start the script, I want to start this animation again. So whenever I'm going to click on this, it will go to its initial position. So every time you start the things, it will be starting from very beginning. Okay. As you already know, to start an event, of course, we need a green flag. So I'll put it somewhere here. Now also, you know that we want it to move. Now, students, yesterday we used this forever, okay, because we wanted it to move again and again and again. But today we are not going to use forever. We are going to use an option of repeat. So what exactly repeat block is? So repeat block will help you to make work any other block which is inside it for a certain number which is present over here. So like if in case I kept this move 10 steps inside the repeat 10 block, so this block will be working for 10 times. I can reduce this number to 5. I can increase this number to any number what I want. Okay, so we'll start with 5. We will see exactly till where the lion moves on the 5 steps. So now you can see it just moved a little bit. So I want some more. So I will just put 10 here and I'll bring it back. So now you can see it moved to a certain place where I wanted it to move. Now I'll just put this, attach this part of blocks to the previous one. Now what exactly it is going to help me? So students, you can see if I'm going to click it here, you can see a small animation where you can see that like lion is moving from one place to another. Okay. Also student, like we know, we use the costumes, right? So yesterday, so costumes are nothing but it's an different pictures of, as I said, like the same sprite, which help us to give a little movement, right? So what I can do, I'll just take a costume. Okay, again, one costume. And you know that we will be in requirement. I'll just select it to B and let's select it to C. And we have already discussed this part yesterday, because if we want to change something, so we want a little weight because we want to see, and also we will add a motion here. Okay, so now let's see whether it works or not. So it is working again, but it is working very slowly. So I can decrease the time. Okay, I'll just decrease the time of wait. So I'll just stop this. Okay, and instead of this wait, I can put 0.5, and I'll put weight of 0.5 here also. So some students were asking this question to me, like how we can increase and decrease the speed of running. So this is how you can decrease and increase the speed. So now you can see it is moreover looking like it is moving towards. So now you just saw it, but now also there was a little problem that we were expecting our lion to be till here, but it went a little far away. So I'll just change this repeat 10 to 8. Okay. And now let's play it again. Okay. So now you can see it just came back. So I'll just again decrease it. So this is called as a testing student. So we were discussing about testing and debugging, right? So right now we are testing it and finding the error or the desired thing. So what we were desiring for, that my lion should move till here only, but it is moving somewhere a little far, like little away. So this is what we are trying to test, that with how many repeats it will come to the best place what we want. So now you can see with the repeat of 5, it just moved to some place, like to the exact place where I wanted it to move. Now we have completed the movement part of the lion. Now again, I also want these same things to happen with fox, that it should also move to a certain point, okay, and which will help me to bring it to near the lion. So again, we will add one thing here. Okay, that is when green flag is clicked, and we will go to repeat, and let's just take repeat for 3 times because the space is very less. Okay, so we'll just try to put it very at the, like we'll give very less repeat number of repeats so that it should not move very far ahead. Also again, you know, one step that we have to set the position. Okay, initial position. So we can set the initial position of the sprite using this go to X and Y, and I'll put it somewhere here. Now the same procedure which we just followed, and again in the costume. So here in the costume, you can see those walking costumes are not here, right? So instead of making fox walk, we can directly ask it to move for 10 steps. So let's see. So you can see now. So we'll just increase this repeat to 5. So now you can see everything is working. So now if I'm going to press green flag, so I will be able to see some part of animation which I have planned. So now you can see the fox moved. Okay, and then lion came back to the place where I wanted it. Now this was a short part. Now the what is next? What I want. So what I want is, I'll just go to lion. Okay, now the first thing, if we meet our friends, what do? We put some hi and hello messages to them, right? So let's do that. So let's bring, say hello. And instead just hello, I'll just put fox. So now I'm putting this into the lion that after once the it says hello fox. Now what I want, student, is it is a very important part and I want everyone to see this, that once you have kept it here, that I want my lion to say fox, that is hello fox. After that, fox should reply with it, right? So how we can do it? So here, student, a concept of broadcasting a message comes in. Okay, so I'll just show you. So in events, you will see a broadcasting. So now what is broadcasting? So you might have heard this word broadcasting of live television matches. Okay, so message matches you see in the TV, it is broadcasted from the stadium. Similarly, what we are broadcasting is a small message. Like we are sending a small message from one sprite to all other sprites. So what I can do is I'll just click on new message. I'll put it hello. So you can name it anything what you want. And after once the lion says hello fox, I am sending a small message internally. Okay, so this is something which we are sending internally. After sending this internally, I also want to listen this word internally, right? So what I'm going to do is there is an option in the event where you can see it says when I receive. And you can choose the same message. So when the second sprite will hear this message coming internally, hello. So what do you want it to do? Yes, of course, we want it to say hello, lion. Okay, so now I just wrote hello, lion. And let's see that whether this part and everything is going to work or not. So now you can see it is working very fine. Now, if in case after say hello lion, I want to add something. So what I can do is I can again add a small message here, like how are you? So now fox will ask how are you? And now student, what I'm going to do is I will again broadcast a small message. So how can I do it is, I'll just put a broadcast message here and instead of hello, I will choose anything else. So let's take it, how are you? So you can keep any name what you want, but it should be you should able to understand it. Okay, so now what is happening? When a message is coming from the lion side, after Fox Sprite is hearing it, it is going to play two blocks, that is hello lion and how are you. And in the lion, now we are going to hear that message. And what, how can I do this is, I'll when I receive, how are you? And what I wanted is my lion should answer with this. Okay, so I'll put it hello here and I'll write I'm good. Yeah, of course, it just say thank you. Thanks. Also, you can put it how like what about you? So after this, lion will ask to fox. Okay, so this is upon you. You can add any number of message, broadcast the message. So now let's see if what we thought of is possible or not. Okay, so now you just saw that how exactly we did. Okay, so now there are some questions which I have been seeing in the previous time also, that a student says, sir, if I want something to change of a backdrop or a background, so how we can do that? So here, students, I will show you. Now let's take one more backdrop. Okay, so let me just find a good backdrop for you. Okay, so let's take pool. Okay, so this is a pool, but I don't think this is looking good. Okay, so I'll just take something else. So let's take this broad walk. Okay, so this will help me to bring certain things and explain you the part. So what I'm going to do is I'm going back to the main script. Okay, and here, students, you have to understand one thing. So this might be a problem coming with you also. So you might see stage selected, no motion block. So students ask, sir, what is it? I'm not able to see the motion blocks. Why? So students, you can see there are three options here, right? First is sprite one, that is lion. Second is sprite two, that is fox. And third, you can also select a stage. So in stage, you are not going to see the motion blocks. So if you want to see the motion blocks, what you have to do is you have to select a sprite. Okay, after selecting a sprite, you will be able to see this. Now, till now we have understood what was the plan. So I'll just show it to you again. So here the lion comes, and once the lion reaches, it asks, hello fox, and it says, hello lion, how are you? And lion reply, I'm good, thanks. Right, after this, what I want lion should ask fox, let's go for drinking water. Okay, so now I'll just put somewhere here so that you will be able to see this. Okay, so now I think you will be able to see this. So here what I did was I just added something like let's go for drinking water. Okay, so what I want, like after certain time, what should happen? This backdrop should change to something else, right? Where the water is. So, but again, you have to set the initial stages. So how can you do that is you have to go to look. So we first, what we did, we set up the initial point of the lion along with it. Now, if we are working with two backdrops, so I also have to set the backdrop so that every time it start, it should start with this backdrop only, that is jungle. Okay, now once I have added let's go for drinking water, what I want here is I want to broadcast a message. Okay, so why I'm broadcasting a message is because I want my fox, right, to answer, and after that the backdrop should change. Drink water. Okay, so I'm just putting in such a way so that you can easily understand, and I'll go to fox, and again I will choose an option, that is when I receive a drink water. And what I want is fox should reply yes. Fox should reply yes, and there should be a small wait of 2 seconds, because of course from going to jungle they should have a small time to reach to the water place. And here, again in the looks, you can change the backdrop. So you just saw this Fox switch costume. So there is an option of switch backdrop. Okay, so this block is going to help you to switch the backdrop from jungle to the water place. Okay. And after it, what I want is, I will again add a small weight, and I want my fox to reply, or I'll just add a fox to reply. Here is the water. Here is the water. Okay, so now I'll just start everything and I'll show you how exactly working, and I'll try to explain you this part again. So let's start with, I'll just go to like full screen and show you this. Okay, so you just saw that how exactly everything worked perfectly, right? So this is how you can send the messages internally. You can change the backdrop. You can work with two sprites. Okay, so now I hope everything is very clear. If it is not, you can ask me the questions. I'll give you a time. So I'll stop my share here. Okay, I'll just stop my share here. And yeah, so if you have any questions, you can. Okay, I can see Garv has mentioned, have done, speak slow. Okay, sure. I'll definitely speak slow. So I'll just ask to promote, sir, like, sir, was everything visible and my voice was clear?
Your voice was clear and your speech was also visible.
Oh, okay.
Actually, some students started misusing chat, so I stopped them so that they could focus on the class, because what you're teaching was very important. But I think you might have to explain a bit more. Some students.
So now, students, so why I have taken it little fast, I'll tell you, students, because now we are going to do somewhat same thing in the phone also, right? So there, now after that, you will be able to understand those things. Okay, you will be, now I'm going to show you the Android part. So I'll just share my screen back. Okay, and now I think you will be able to see my Android screen. So students, you have to just see it very clearly. Okay, just try to understand what am I doing. If you are not able to follow me now, it's not a problem. Okay, you can see the replay video and do the things very easily. So now let's start. Okay, so the first thing, what does this play button gives you? So this will direct you to the directly to the scripting area, the PictoBlox main page, but that will direct you to the old program. Okay, this will direct you to the program which you were working previously. So what should you do? You should go to MySpace, click on MySpace. Okay, so let me, now you can see MySpace, and here you can see a plus button. Okay, so here you have to click on plus button. So let me just check this option of full screen if it is possible. Yeah, it's good. So now you, what you have to do is you have to click on plus screen. So now if once you click on the plus screen, student, it will take you to the main page. So let it come. I'll just show it to you. So now you can see everything clearly on the Android app. So now I will just repeat those steps. Okay. And I'll explain those things again. So this will give you more clarity. Okay. So now how can I do it is first important thing, that how can I add an sprite? So in the center area, you can see an add sprite option. Just click on this add sprite option. Sprite library will open automatically. Okay, so now here, students, as we did in the like, now you can see that how we can choose the different sprite. So I'm going to make a story on fox and lion. So I'll just choose animals here. Okay, and I'll just bring the lion. So now you can see a lion coming up on the stage along with the Toby. The next step what we did was we deleted that sprite. So how we can do that? If I want to delete Toby, so I'll just click on Toby. And once I click on Toby, you will see three options. And the third option is to delete. So now you can see three options. I'll just click it again for you. And I'll just click on the last one. Okay. So this is the delete option, which comes up on the, you can see on the screen. That is the third option is to delete. First is to paint and second is to copy. Okay. So now students, we have added one sprite. What was our second option? Second thing what we wanted to do, we wanted to add one more sprite. So I'll just click on add sprite again. It will again take me to the sprite library. And the same thing what we did previously, I'm going to just search fox here. So F-O-X, okay. And once you have written it, just select go. Okay, so you can directly select in sprite, I can see, okay. So you can directly select in sprite. Okay, so now you might be seeing some options coming up. Don't forget to save, don't forget to save. So it is very important, students, because what we want you to do is like you keep saving it, because if you are going to move out of this project without saving, so these steps what you have done is going to is going to be deleted. So we all want you to like keep it saving after a certain time so that you can keep track of the things and you don't get a loss of data. Okay, so what I can do is I'll just put lion, fox, story. Okay, so I'll just keep here, okay. After doing this, just click on done option. And let me just give you, if you are able to see it, it's good. But if whenever I'm clicking on the screen, you will see a small dot coming, okay. So this will help you to understand where exactly I'm clicking. So I just clicked on the save button. Okay, I'll just click on the type project name. So you will see a small dot coming there. And I'll just write this again, Fox Lion Story. And I'll just click on done. And I'll just click on save. So it will save. You will see the option. It will come as project save. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move my sprites here and there. Okay, because I want a little changes over that. Okay, so now other steps are going to be very similar. But let me explain you some of them again, because this will give you a much more clarity. The next step what we did was choosing a backdrop. So how can you do that? So you can see the first option here. This is the first option which will help you to choose the backdrop. So if I'm going to click on choose a backdrop, okay, so you will see one notice, you will notice one thing. So you can see the motion blocks are not visible. So if you find anything like this, you don't have to worry. You are on the correct way. There is no problem. If you are going to choose backdrop, you are not going to see anything. If you are going to see the sprite, you can see the motion blocks and the script, whatever you are going to write for that sprite. Okay. So how can we choose a backdrop comes the question. So you will just click on the backdrop. Now you will again click on the backdrop and you will see a edit option coming there. Okay, so now you can see an edit option coming there. So you have to click on that edit option. and you will be reaching to the backdrop setting option. Here you have an option to choose a backdrop. And where is it? So you can see this is the first option which will help you to choose a backdrop. So I'll just select this. So now it will open a backdrop library. And again, I will just choose any backdrop. So let's this time take this forest. Okay, once you are satisfied with the backdrop, you can click on, you have to click on go back button on the top. And once you will be reaching this part, and then you have to click on the sprites. Okay, so I'm just clicking on lion, which will give me the all the blocks. So again, it will ask you to, like, every time you put it something new, it is going to ask you, don't forget to save, because definitely we don't want you to have a loss of data, right? So now what I can do is I can fix some positions of my lion. Okay. And as I explained you just before, that how do we fix this? We take go to X and go to Y. So this is, you can see right now fox has been selected. And so this position has been set for the fox. I'll just select for the lion as well. So I selected the lion sprite and added this go to X and Y for lion as well. And I'll also put the block which says when green flag is clicked in both the scripts. So I just choose when green flag is clicked. Now again, the things will remain same. So I'll just give you a little idea, okay, how we are doing it. So now I want it to move. Okay, so I'll just go to the control, bring repeat. And right now I'm not putting all the same things which we did earlier. Okay, because this is to just show you how you are doing the things. The blocks and everything you can understand very easily from the laptop also. Okay, which I just showed you. Okay, so now I'll just take move 10 steps here. Okay, so now again, I just use the move 10 step. And I also want to change the costumes. So I'll add costume A, and here I'll add costume. I'll just change to costume B, and I'll just change to costume C. You know, we have to add a little weight so that we can see the changes in switch in costume. Okay, I'll just bring it little up so that you will be able to see it. Okay. I'm sorry. So now, students, instead of one, what I'm going to choose is 0.5. So this might give you sometimes trouble. So students think how we are going to put 0.5. So see, you have to put zero. Okay, and on the right side, in just behind done, you can see point and dash. So if you are going to press this and leave it, so it will bring something like this. Okay, if you are going to just press once, it is going to bring the point. So you don't have to worry. So what is it? So you have to just click this and the point will come automatically. Okay, you have to click 0.5 and click on done. Okay, so here you can see now it came 0.5. I'll again put it to 0.5 and I'll just press done. Okay, so now if I want to see how exactly my lion is working, what I can do is, so students, on the right hand side, on the bottom corner, you will see a full screen option. Okay, so this is the full screen option. So I can just click on full screen and you will be able to see this. Okay, and let's press green flag. So you can see a green flag over here. So now you can see the lion is moving somewhat the same in the screen, right? So now I'll go to, means I'll just go back to the main screen. And I'll just fix some of the things with the fox. So now once you'll come back here, you won't be able to see the stage. So you can see, students, there are some options on the right hand side. Okay, so right hand side, the first option is to show and to hide the stage. So this is the option which will help you to show and hide the stage. So if you're not able to see the stage, just click on the first option, which will bring up the stage for you. And in the stage, you can see there is an eye. Okay, so if you are going to click on that eye, it will hide your stage. So if you want to bring it back, you can just click on the first option to bring it here. And now what I'll do is I'll just fix some of the things. I'll go to Fox. Okay, so I have like set the event, like I have set the position, initial position, but I also wanted to point change the direction. So what I'm doing here is I'll just change this to minus 90, which you have already seen. And now you can see minus 90, what it gave. It just rotated my Fox. And I also want, so by mistakely, I just went into the lion place. So I also want it to be C straight. So I'll just go and set the rotation style. And this will help me to bring up the Fox back again. Okay. So now you can set the things. So what I can do is instead of go to X and Y, this, I'll just keep it little back. Okay. And I'll just change this where I want initial position to somewhere here. Okay. And let's see how exactly it is working. So I'll again go to the full screen and I'll just press the green flag. So I just press the green flag. So you will be able to see the everything coming up on the screen, like lion is moving towards the Fox. So you can see lion just came near to the Fox. Now other things are going to be very, very similar. You don't have to like worry for it. Like again, you can see the other things, like right now the Fox has selected. I'll just bring the stage for you. Okay, so other things will remain very same, that is broadcasting the message. So right now, if I want to first I want my lion to say something, so I'll add it hello. And also I can change it to hello, and I'll just change it to hello lion. Okay, and I'll just press done here. And again, the blocks are going to be very, very same. Not very, very same, but it's exactly same what we have done in the laptop part. So what I'm going to do in event, I'll just bring a broadcast message. Oh, sorry, that's not this one. Yes, this one. Broadcast message. I'll just edit the message, create a new message here, writing hello, and just done. And I'll just press OK here. Okay, so I'm just pressed sending a message internally. So you know it will send it internally to like all the sprites. I'll just go back to Fox. I'll just hear this. So here is something what I'm hearing, that when I'm receiving this hello message, what I want is it should reply with hello lion. Okay, so now I have kept it hello lion. And if you want to also change the backdrop, so you can do it very easily. You have to again go to backdrop option, just select one more backdrop. Okay, so similar way we did it previously, like backdrop setting, going to choose a backdrop, and let's take any other, let's take a beach. So right now you can see after once you select a beach will come in here. Okay, so you have to select forest again, go back, and very important concept, I just brought this change in backdrop because I wanted to make this very clear to all of you that initial steps should be very fixed. So every time, if you are changing a backdrop, but there should be a little fixing at the initial stage, from where you want it to start. So what I want is every time it starts, it should start with backdrop one, or not the backdrop one, but the forest one. Okay, so I'll just stop this. It started just playing. So I want this. Okay, I'll go back to Fox. And here I wanted it to get changed. So I'll just bring a switch backdrop here. And now I want it to be beach. Okay. So now you can see it is something what we did previously. Okay. And now let's see whether it's working perfectly or not. So I'll just go to the full screen and I'll just press green flag again. So it's something what we have written, we will be able to see. So first we set the initial stage that I want this backdrop. I want my lion to be in this place. I want my fox to be this place. Then there was a little conversation and there was a change of backdrop. So now I think this part is very, very clear, but most important thing is don't forget to save, because every time, if even you are moving out of this window of PictoBlock, this might give you a loss of data. So it's better that you keep saving the things, because if you're making a big project, it's very important you keep saving. So just keep it saved. Okay, so now this part I think is very clear to everyone. Okay, so I will be explaining some more part about how we can submit the project and everything. So I'll just stop my share as of now so that I can take you to the things. Okay, so I won't stop the share. Let's continue from here itself. Okay, so now you have already saved it. So, but where you can find this? So students, you are going to find this when you are going to click this back option. So this will take you, so it will again ask you, so do you want it to save? So you have to click again on the save. Once you have saved this, so you will be able to see that project in your space, okay, in your MySpace every time. And now I will teach you how you can share this to us and where you have to share with us. So here, these are many projects, but let me just take you to the latest one, which we have made, which is Fox and Lion Story. So you can see it here. So now see it very clearly that how we are working with it is, if you want to share it, okay, if you have to submit the assignment. So how you are going to submit the assignment, I'm now telling you this part from phone, then I'll tell you how you can do it from your laptop also, so you don't have to worry. So now students, I'll just, you can see on MySpace, click Lion and Fox Story, or I should say Fox and Lion Story, and keep a deep press. So you will be able to see a tick over here. So it means that you have selected this file. After selection, on the top, you can see there is an option. There are four options. So you have to choose the first one, which is getting a link. And once you will click on here. Okay, so here is a little requirement here. Let me just take care of it also, because some of the students, you were asking for it. So you have to sign into the PictoBlock. So I'll just take 2 more minutes, because everyone needs to be signed into the PictoBlocks. So now how can you do it? So students, on this page, just listen it very, very carefully, okay? And follow the same process. So you have to click on the first, that is sign in. Okay, here you have to click on register. Once you will be clicking on register, so you are a student, just click on a student. After that, you have to select your age. So whether are you older than 16 or no. So whether you are selecting yes or you are selecting no, you will be allowed to use the PictoBlocks. You don't have to worry for it. So let's select no. And here you need to give the details. Once you will be giving the details here, like the first is the email. So let me give you, let me just write an email here. Okay, so now I have kept it username. So I need to put a username here. Okay, so yeah. So what can be the username? So here, students, you have to see that you are putting everything in small. Okay, you have to put. So I'll just remove this. Actually, it's bringing something else. So you have to put some username. It can be anything. So I'll just choose. Ayush underscore MI. So that is not MI actually, that is MAI, that is Mission Artificial Intelligence, right? So now you can see the ticks even on the right hand side, that everything is going perfectly. I'll just put a password, so you can keep anything for the password which you should remember. Okay, so I can put it something like anything. I'm not going to tell you. Okay, so I just kept the password, and now I have to click. Okay, I'll just take this and I'll just click on create my account. And what exactly is the next step is, students, it will be sent. So it is asking me to save the password. I can just keep it, put it save. So it is going to help me. So now it will come like waiting for the approval. So what exactly is the approval is, it will be sent. It will be sending you an email on your email ID. Okay. So you have to like go to your email option. Okay. And then you have to like click on verify. So I'll just try to show you that. I'll just stop my share here so that I can take you to that part. So I'll just share you my screen back again. So you might see this also, students. Just give me a moment. I'll just show it to you. Okay, so I'll just share my screen back. So you might see sometimes this option. Okay, so it will say you haven't verified the things in your email. Please verify. So you have to like go to your email and verify it. Okay, so you might have received an email. So I'll just check whether I have received it or not. So for that, I need to just go to my emails. So let me just try to like switch on my email part. Okay, so see, you will receive. Okay, so students, you will receive an email. Okay, and you have to verify. So I have not received it yet now, but it takes a little bit of time, and definitely I don't want you to wait for it. Okay, so I'll just share my screen back. So what you can do is you can okay, so if in case you haven't received, you can click on verify now, and you can ask it to resend an email. And if you are going to say ask it for resend, and it will again resend you an email. Once you will receive an email, you have to like basically go and click on activate my account. Once it is activated, what you have to do is you have to come back here, and I'll just show you how you can sign in. Okay, so once you will be coming back here, you will be already signed in, but if you want to like sign in with your username and password, so you can put your username and password. So I'll choose my old one. Okay, and always remember, don't put your email ID in place of username. Okay, so you have to always sign in using this option, that putting a username and the password. And once it is done, you have to click on sign in. So I'm just waiting for, yeah. So now you can see, I'll just click on sign in and it will make me sign in into the PictoBlocks. Okay. So once you have signed in, so we were like somewhere like how we can share the project. Okay. So what you have to do is now you have to go to MySpace. Just do the same steps what we were doing, that you have to like select that project. Okay, once you will see a tick over here, it means it is selected. You have to click on the first option, which is this one. Okay, so it will say creating a global link. Okay, so basically you don't have to share your file, but you have to share your link. Okay, so this will create a global link here. So it will just coming up. It will take a little bit of time. So we want you to like wait for a little time. So be patient with it, because it will take a little bit, like a 1 minute time, students, because basically it is converting all your projects to a link. And now you can see a link over here, right? So you have to click on copy to clipboard. Okay, so this will copy your link. And now, students, what you have to do is you have to go to the place in the dashboard. So I'll directly move it there. Okay, so here I wanted to explain two to three things. So here I'm already logged in, so I'll log out myself to show you this. Okay, so now you can see it is asking. So what you have to do is you have to click on login. I'll go inside it. And you can see this option coming now. Okay, so we have activated this option where you can chat with us. And here, students, you have to be very focused and see it, that once you are reached to dashboard, go just scroll it down, click on explore more. Once you will be clicking on explore more, it will direct you to the AI Bootcamp batch 2 page. And here, students, what you have to do is you have to go inside the first session, that is introduction to programming and artificial intelligence. And also we have covered the second also. Okay, so the yesterday part, you will be putting it inside the first one. Okay, so walking animation has to be submitted on the first one. And today's part, you will be submitting on the second one, that is B2. So right now, as I have copied a story, so I'll go to the basics of programming. And here inside it, you will be able to do the things very easily. So let it come. So here you will be able to see the content if you want to take a revision. Okay. And if you want to take a revision, you can just choose this. I'll just go back to, sorry, introduction to programming one, the first one. I'm sorry. So here basically you will be able to see the replay video. Okay, so this is a replay video of the first session. And after this, you will be also able to see the slide. Okay, so you can see whatever we have taught you on the first. And here you can see there is an option, introduction to artificial intelligence quiz. So this is basically you have to complete, a student. So now you can see this quiz will start here. So you have to click on start quiz. And here, so you can, you have to complete this quiz. So like, I'll just explain you for the first, like it is asking which block palette is used to control the sprite movement. So you know, this is motion. Okay, so after it, I'll also, let me like give you one more hint. So here, rearrange the following three steps of programming. So you know, you have to take this to the first. Okay, first is planning, second is writing, and third is testing. And now here it is written, submit the link to the Toby walking project. So here you have to paste that link. Okay, so you have to paste that link here. And once you will be pasting that link, it will take you to the next part. So you have to paste that link. Okay, and after that you have to complete all other questions. Once you are done, then you can click on finish quiz. If you are not able to complete it, you will be able to reattempt it. You don't have to worry. Okay, and but this is the steps you have to follow. I think this will be very easy. If I'll be able to just show you once again, let me just give you a brief idea. So what we did was we just copied the link from the application. I'll just click it here. I'll just go to first one. And you can see the replay video of the lecture one here. You can see the session PPT with the presentation which we have taught you here. You can also, you have to just click on introduction to programming and artificial intelligence, click on start quiz and start putting your answers over here. And then you have to paste that link over this question, that is submit the link to the Toby walking project. And be very careful by putting this link. So like you have to put the link of Toby walking project. Okay, so keep try to put the names of the files clearly. Now, if you are doing it on your, I should say the laptop or desktop. So what you have to do is, so this will be something, a screen would be looking something like this. So you will be making the files, okay? So you will be saving it also. Also, you will get an option under the file to generate a file sharing link. Okay, so when, like, let me just give you a small idea. So what I can do, I'll just take the random blocks here. Okay, I know like now you have to click on file, just click on generate the file link and it will ask you to hold. Okay, and now after it, the link will be coming up here. And now you can see you have to click on copy link. Once it will be copied, you have to go back to your place and you can paste the link here. Okay, so this is how you are going to do it from laptop or desktop. Also, you are going to do everything with your Android phones. So everything I like we have covered, I'll just stop my share here and I'll come back to you all. So yeah, so how to do in laptop. So I think I have like just explained you. I'll just share my screen back and just give you a little glance so that no confusion remains. So in desktop, you will be able to do it by an option which is under the file, that is generate file sharing link. It will generate a link and you can copy that. So yeah, I hope everything is clear. And like I think I have already taken 10 minutes ahead, but I think many things are completed.
Very nice.
And also, I'll just take one moment, sir. Actually, a very important thing I wanted to show. So students, as I said, like there is a place you can talk to us, right? So how you can do it is, so you will be able to see when you'll go to like your dashboard or in the website when you are going to go. So because this is very, very important part. So I want everyone to see this. So here, students, you will be able to see a chat option. Okay, so here you will be able to chat with us. So you can chat with us, just click on this chat option. Okay, so you can ask your questions with us. And what we want you to do is, like every time you are using this chat option, okay, try to give your details completely so that we will be able to reach to you. Okay, so like if I want, like you can see chat with Ayusha, it's written. So like if you want to talk to me, like any doubt you have, like if I ask what is the, participation process. Okay, so you can just directly send this question to me. Okay, and it will ask you first a question that please introduce yourself. So please keep your details here very correctly, because there might be a time that I won't be able to reply you directly on the first go, but I will reach out to you on the email which you are going to provide me. Okay, so like if I will be available, I will directly answer your questions here. If in case I'm not available, I will answer your questions on the email ID which you are going to give it on the form. Okay, so I think this will be very clear and it's wonderful. We will be talking, we will be clearing your doubts on the live basis, and this will also enable you to understand each and everything. So this is the way now we are going to contact. I would recommend this rather than connecting on the WhatsApp, because this will give us a better idea and better solutions to help, because we will be able to help you directly from this. And like, because in WhatsApp sometimes I'm available, I'm not not available, internet is available, internet is not available. But in this, we and my team will be try to answer you all your questions. If you have any questions, please reach out to us using this chat option on the website. Okay, just very important thing, while we are sending your questions, please give your details very correctly, because we will be reaching out to your in email also responding your answer. So yeah, so this was all I wanted to cover for today. Okay, and yeah, so this was all. Yeah, over to you, Pramod.
Thank you, Ayush. This was a very wonderful session today. I know a lot of students still have to grasp everything you said. So first of all, they should, as you said, now we are into the second day. So the picture blocks mastery is something now they have to complete. All the things you have shown in the dashboard and everything, all students need to go through it, practice it. If you have any questions, like Ayush just showed you how to ask your questions through the direct chat. So yes, we are there with you 24 hours throughout the day. But it is you who has to do the work. So now please go back to your picture blog. I saw a lot of people talking in the chat and not paying attention to what Ayush was saying. So fine, you have another chance. They can go back, look at the recording, pick up whatever Ayush has said, and make sure that today they practice what has been taught today. Because if you leave it for tomorrow, by tomorrow you will forget. So then you will not learn anything worthwhile. If you really want to master artificial intelligence, start practicing, start completing your assignments on the same day. But I know, in the beginning it will take some time, so maybe do it by tomorrow, but do it. That is about it, because what we are trying to tell you is that this is all learning you can get by experience only, not by listening to any lecture. The moment you have done these two tasks, then we will start getting into the actual artificial intelligence techniques like vision, sound, listening, talking, everything you do. We learn how to make our mobile smart, our laptop smart, our home smart. So the real exciting part is starting now. But just now you have to make sure you have absolutely clear in your mind about picture block, about the command, about the dashboard, about everything we have taught you in these 2 days. If you have mastered this, you'll have no trouble in artificial intelligence. And if you do not master this just now, then you will not be able to pick up what we are going to teach from tomorrow. So all the best. Put your mind into it and really go into it, because these are two very interesting things we done. Animation, yes, as I said, the project Ayush has said, this has to be done. But anybody wants to make another story, he's welcome. And he should do that. Create new animation, create new stories, practice, practice and practice until you become the master. That is correct, Ayush? So now, basically, yeah. I think this time, these 2 days, they have to concentrate. You have to make sure everybody is registering, everybody is able to access. All the questions which are coming in now, this thing will be resolved. But by tomorrow, I want to see almost everybody up to date with picture blocks and whatever we have said. So this is important. The first 2 days are the foundation on which you start actually make your artificial intelligence understanding grow. These two were the foundation. But now we start the AI journey. So again, today practice, practice, tomorrow is Sunday, practice, practice, until it is coming out to your ears, whatever time you get, you do it. You do it. And you really enjoy it afterwards. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Ayu. It's a very wonderful thing. To go forward to tomorrow's session. That is even better.
Sure.
Yeah. Anything else you want to say?
So I'll just take a poll with the students, like, is everything was clear on today's session? So students, can I have your response? Okay, we can see a good response. Okay, because see, if you are not clear, you have two options now. The first is we will be getting, I'm sorry, you will be getting a replay video. So you can see it again and again and again. You can learn everything again. There is no problem. Other than that, if you are facing a problem, please feel free to reach us through the chat you can see on the website. Okay, so this will be again. So we all, like me, Pramod sir, Pankaj sir, Prem sir, we all are trying to reach to you so that your each and every problem is solved and your focus should be on evolving the artificial intelligence from you inside. Okay, so that's why we are helping you in each and every step, that your problems are resolved by us. Each and every problem will be resolved by us, and you focus on the vision. What our like mentors like Pramod sir and Dr. Prem sir and our principal sir has brought up. So we want you to focus on that and leave every problem to us. We are going to help you and resolve it. So that was all from my side. And yeah, thank you again, all teachers, students and parents for joining it. Be a part of it, attend it regularly, submit your assignments, and hope you are enjoying it very well. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, see you tomorrow. See you everybody tomorrow. Thank you. Go enjoy yourself.
You.
Go and practice. Thank you. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Yeah. Now you can close the session.
Sure, sir.
Yeah. Okay.